Hello everyone, I am Dr. C. Yogambal, working as an assistant professor, Department of Physics, St. Joseph College of Arts and Science, Cuddalore. Now I am going to discuss about rectifier and its types. What do you mean by rectifier? It is a device which converts the alternating current signal into direct current signal. As I told earlier, rectifier is an electrical device that converts alternating current to direct current. This process is called rectification. We can use single phase or multiphase of alternating current signal by input. The output can be obtained by fixed or variable. Using rectifier, the alternating current which periodically reverses direction to direct current which flows in only one direction. This process is known as rectification since it straightens the direction of current. Physically, rectifiers take a number of forms, including vacuum tube diodes, mercury arc valves, semiconductor diodes, silicon controlled rectifiers. The rectifier can be used in various applications such as direct current welder, direct current motor drive, battery charger, direct current power supply, high voltage direct current. The rectifiers are mainly classified into two types. One is half wave rectifier, the second one is full wave rectifier. In half wave rectifier, we are using single diode only, but in full wave rectifier, we are using two diodes such as D1 and D2. Now we will discuss the half wave rectifier and full wave rectifier one by one in detail. What do you mean by half wave rectifier? Positive half cycle of the AC input signal which converts into pulsating DC output signal. Here, the remaining half signal of the negative cycle is blocked or lost. The circuit diagram of the half wave rectifier is shown in the figure. Here, we are using AC input signal P1, P2 as a primary coil, S1, S2 as a secondary coil, diode, load resistor, and transformer. In AC signal, we have positive half cycle and negative half cycle. We will discuss about the components and their uses one by one. First one, AC source. The AC source supplies alternating current to the circuit. The alternating current is represented by the sinusoidal waveform. Second one, transformer. It is a device which reduces or increases the AC voltage. Step-down transformer reduces the AC voltage from high to low, whereas The step up transformer increases the AC voltage from low to high. In half wave rectifier, we generally use a step down transformer because the voltage needed for the diode is very small. So we use step down transformer in half wave rectifier. However, in some cases we may use a step up transformer. In the step down transformer, the primary winding has more turns than the secondary winding. So the step down transformer reduces the voltage from primary winding to secondary winding. Third one, diode. A diode is a two terminal device that allows electric current in one direction and blocks electric current in another direction. Fourth one, resistor. A resistor is an electronic component that restricts the current flow to a certain level. When high AC voltage, which is have 60 hertz, is applied, the step down transformer reduces high voltage into low voltage so that the low voltage is produced at the secondary winding of the transformer. The produced low voltage at the secondary winding of the transformer is called secondary voltage. When low AC voltage is applied to the diode during the positive off cycle of the signal, the diode is forward biased and allows electric current, whereas during the negative off cycle, the diode is reverse biased and blocks electric current. Working principle of half wave rectifier. The diode allows the positive off cycle of the input AC signal and blocks the negative off cycle of the input AC signal. Thus, the half wave rectifier allows positive off cycles and blocks negative off cycles. The half wave rectifier, which allows positive off cycles and blocks negative off cycles, is called a positive half wave rectifier. The output direct current or direct current signal produced by a positive half wave rectifier is a series of positive half cycles or positive sinusoidal pulses. This series of positive pulses is not a pure direct current. It is a pulsating direct current. The pulsating direct current changes its value over a short period of time. But our aim is to produce a direct current which does not change its value over a short period of time. Therefore, the pulsating direct current is not much useful. While giving the alternating current as input for the off-wave rectifier, we can obtain positive off-cycle as an output. The negative off-cycle will be blocked. What is full-wave rectifier? A full-wave rectifier is a type of rectifier which converts both off-cycles of the AC signal into pulsating DC signal. We are using two diodes, D1 and D2, which converts positive and negative both wave into output of DC signal. In full wave rectifier, we are using two diodes and also the center tap transformer has been used in full wave rectifier. When the additional wire is connected across the middle of the secondary winding of a transformer is known as center tap transformer. The wire is adjusted in such a way that it falls in the exact middle point of the secondary winding. So the wire is exactly at 0 volts of the AC signal. This wire is known as the center tap. A center tap transformer has another important feature, that is the secondary winding of the center tap transformer divides the input AC current or AC signal into two parts. The upper part of the secondary winding produces a positive voltage V1, and the lower part of the secondary winding produces a negative voltage V2. When we combine these two voltages at output load, we get a complete AC signal V total equal to V1 plus V2. Working principle of full wave rectifier. The center tapped full wave rectifier uses a center tap transformer to convert input AC voltage into output DC voltage. When input AC voltage is applied, the secondary winding of the center tapped transformer divides the input AC voltage into two parts, positive and negative. During the positive off cycle of the input AC signal, terminal A become positive, terminal B become negative, and center tapped is grounded 0 volt. The positive terminal A is connected to the P side of the diode D1 and the negative terminal B is connected to the N side of the diode D2. So the diode D1 is forward biased during the positive off cycle and allows electric current through it. On the other hand, the negative terminal B is connected to the B side of the diode D2 and the positive terminal A is connected to the N side of the diode D2. So, the diode D2 is reverse biased during the positive off cycle and does not allow electric current through it. The diode D1 supplies direct current to the load resistor, then the direct current produced at the load RL will return to the secondary winding through a center tap. During the positive off cycle, current flows only in the upper part of the circuit, while the lower part of the circuit carry no current to the load because the diode D2 is reverse biased. Thus, during the positive off cycle of the input AC signal, only diode D1 allows electric current, while diode D2 does not allow electric current. During the negative off cycle of the input AC signal, terminal A become negative, terminal B become positive, and center tap is grounded. The negative terminal A is connected to the P side of the diode D1 and the positive terminal B is connected to the N side of the diode D1. So, the diode D1 is reverse biased during the negative off cycle and does not allow electric current through it. The diode D2 supplies direct current to the load RL. The direct current produced at the load RL will return to the secondary winding through a center tap. During the negative off cycle, current flows only in the lower part of the circuit, while the upper part of the circuit carry no current to the load because the diode D1 is reverse biased. Thus, during the negative off cycle of the input AC signal, only diode D2 allows electric current, while diode D1 does not allow electric current. Thus, the diode D1 allows electric current during the positive off cycle, and diode D2 allows electric current during the negative off cycle of the input AC signal. As a result, both off cycle, positive and negative, of the input AC signal are allowed. So, the output DC voltage is almost equal to the input AC voltage. The output waveforms of full wave rectifier shows the D1 and D2, both positive and negative cycle of the output signal. When it is combined, the continuous waveforms occur in the total output waveform. Thank you.